You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
Okay, next I'm going to show you how to edit a layer that has Mocha tracking data in it. So first I'm going to create a layer here. I'm going to focus on this section here. I need to make a tracking shape. And I just want to try to capture this edge and we'll see what we get. So B, I'll make something that goes a little bit down towards the shoulder and right below this bang area here. Okay, then we'll go to the Mocha Tracker, Tracking tab, Mocha Tracker, and I want to capture translation, scale, and rotation. So we'll just do some tracking. Shift Z. Back to the beginning. Okay, so you can sort of see here that my shape drifts in, but it doesn't really drift in. It's still capturing my original tracking area, but because she rotates her head, it reveals more of the hair towards the beginning of the shot. So I still like the movement and the rotation, and I'm gonna see if I can edit this tracking data. So what you can do is you can go to, first we'll just name the layer, screen right, mid, hair. And I'm going to turn off my tracking shape and I'm going to go down to the transform area here. I'm just going to pull up the sash and go out of tracking mode so I can just kind of see things a little bit better. Actually, what I want to do is turn on my shape just to see where it starts to drift. Or change is probably around 138. But what I can do to help me make my keyframes is I can just drop in a real shape that follows the edge. And I'll probably edit this a little bit, of course, but this will give us a better idea of how exact I need to be when I make my changes. So we'll turn off the tracking shape again. And you can see kind of follows a little bit off at the end. So what I'm going to do here is it's kind of in place for this frame. I'm going to make a keyframe on the transform controls in the object parameters here. So I'm going to make keyframes just clicking on these four parameters here. And then when I get towards the beginning, I'm actually going to slide my position so that my shape lines up at the edge of the hair. So this is a little bit of a quick demo of this. It can be a little more exacting, but you sort of get the idea. Move that in and towards the end if I want to. So this way, when I drop in shapes into this layer, that it's going to actually, my shapes will line up. Because you can't edit the actual tracking shape and have that be the tracking data. You actually have to transform actually on top of the existing data. So this is like another layer of keyframes on top of the tracking data. It's time to move on from the hair roto portion of the class. There are many ways to approach hair roto shots as no two shots are the same. I hope the instruction on methodology and technique has been helpful. Next up is to work on the screen left hand.